Hi, welcome to an NX 11 video tutorial. I want to do this hair dryer casing in NX. I did this almost 5 years ago, now in HD and with audio commentary, and I did it completely with sheets. So let's have some fun with Siemens NX. So let's start with a sketch, maybe on the YZ plane. Okay, I need a spline, so there you go, through points, yes, and this should look something like that, and closed. Okay, now let's move those points a little bit and just align them. And those two should be aligned vertical. Yeah, and this should the sketch origin. So let's try once again. There you go. Now move this a little bit up, this a little bit down, like this, and give it some dimensions. This should be 50. And that should be, let's say, 30. And it should be symmetric somehow, so I will do it with construction lines. Okay, make them for construction only. And align those vertical. Like this, and it's symmetric. Maybe move this a little bit more up like that. That's okay. Now finish that sketch. And I want to do it as similar as possible to the Katia version. But as the sweeps from Katia are not available right here, there are section surfaces, but therefore I would need some more input elements. So I will do it in a different way. So we'll go for an extrude. And length should be 100. I will go for a sheet and I want to add a draft. So the curve would be this one and the vector in that direction, and just add a draft from section, and it should be, I think, -5 degrees or 5 degrees. Let's take a look. Yeah, that's okay, and confirm. Now let's go for a fill. I could hide the sketch. I will use a fill surface with that edge. And continuity G1, that's okay. Yeah, that's okay. And confirm. Nice. Now let's sew those two together, and okay. I will go only for half of that surface, so I have to trim it, trim sheet. Let's trim that sheet body, with this plane. And I want to keep this one. Nice. Now another sketch. On that plane, and this should be a circle, and diameter might be 150. Now let's move this maybe over here. Yes, finish that sketch. Now let's make an extrude. Again, it should be a sheet, and in that direction, turn it around. Again, it's 100, and the draft should be 5 degrees from section. That's okay. And I need it in the other direction as well, so I will go for minus 45, for example. Yeah, let's go for minus 50. That should do the trick. Let's take a look. Yeah, looks good to me. And confirm. Now I need an offset of this one. So go for surface, offset surface. I need an offset to this one. And reverse the direction and make it 2 millimeters. Okay. Now let's trim. I want to trim my sheet. I want to trim this one with that surface right here. I went for keep and I selected this, so this should work. Apply, yeah, and now trim that one with this one. So that would be this trimmed sheet, and I want to discard the selected. Yes, okay. Let's hide for a moment that extrude. Let's say the, not the extrude, but the offset surface looks good. Now sew this surface and that surface, and okay. Now another sketch on that plane right here. Okay. And this should look something like that. Maybe like this, and okay. Now this should be tangent. Maybe it's already tangent. Yeah, it's already tangent. This one as well. Yes, it's already tangent as well. Great. Didn't notice. So let's trim. This should be trimmed and close. Finish that sketch and make an extrude. Again, a sheet with that sketch right here, and one direction it should be 0. Turn it around, and this might be, yeah, 50. That's okay. And confirm. Now show that offset surface. and I want to trim surface trim sheet. I want to trim this one, and this should be removed with that one. Apply. Then I want to trim this one with that surface right here. Okay. And then I want to trim this one with that one. Seems this doesn't work. That's sort of crazy, but yeah, it sort of worked, but the trim command is not as good as the adding katia. So now I have to trim that surface right here with this one. That's a trimmed sheet, so go for body faces, yes, and I want to keep the selected. Yeah, this looks good. Now hide that sketch. And try to sew this together. So go for sew. This one, that one, and this one. Yeah. Now some fillets. Home. Where's my edge blend? And I want to go for 5. And I want to make this edge and that edge. Apply. And 1 millimeter for this edge and that one. Okay. Yeah, looks pretty good. And another edge blend right there, and this might be 5 millimeter. And okay. Very nice. Hide that sketch. Now I need a line. So maybe I should move the first big circle a little bit with that sketch. Maybe a little bit in that direction. Finish that sketch. So I got a little bit more space right here. Hide that sketch. Now I need to project a line. First I need a line, so I go for a sketch on that plane right here. Okay, and I need a line which should go like this, maybe. Yeah, finish that sketch and now project that curve onto that surface. So go for curve, project curve, this curve to that surface, and the direction would be the y direction. And okay, hide that sketch. I did a circular sweep in Katia, so I will go for a section surface. There you go. and I will use the circular one with center and radius. That's the same as in Katia. So select the start guide, would be this one, and it should be constant, yes, and the value should be, I will go for 2 millimeter. Let's take a look. Spine is the same, and I will go for a sheet and okay. Now let's trim sheet. I want to trim this one. I want to keep that section, yes, and with that one apply. So this went wrong. Cancel, go back. So I want to remove, let's take a look. I want to remove, so go for trim sheet and maybe first trim that one. This one, yes. I want to discard that side, and the boundary should be that one. And I want to, yeah, sorry, go to the boundary, select that one, and I'm told this doesn't trim that because it's not a boundary, and I wanted to keep. Let's take a look if it works. It did somehow, but the other way around. Let's try. I want to discard. Okay, that's more like it. Okay, now trim again. Maybe hide that sketch, the projected curve. And now trim. I want to remove this, but I want to keep that, so I will go for discard. Select this one. The boundary should be that surface. And again, I forgot to click right here. That's the boundary. And I want to discard the selected. Yeah. Looks good. Now add some fillets. Edge blend. Let's go for 1 millimeter. But first I have to sew. I didn't sew it. So where is it? Sew this one, that one, and this one. Okay, now I can do my fillet. Edge blend 1 millimeter on this edge and that edge. Okay, and maybe change the radius from 2 to 1. Let's take a look. Yeah, that's okay. And my pipe is okay. Now make a mirror. Go for more mirror geometry. I want to mirror this geometry with that plane. Okay, and again sew it, surface, sew this one with that one, and okay. You could put these features into one feature group and call this the pipe. a tube, whatever you want, and OK. I did those cuts before I mirrored it, so I will go before the mirror, right there, make this the current feature. Yep. And I need a sketch, and I could do this on this plane, or I could add another plane. So go for another plane, home, datum plane, distance to this one, not an add angle, but at distance, and this might be, yeah, let's go for 55. Okay, now do a sketch on that plane, and I want to have three lines. One line right here, another one maybe like this, and another one maybe like that. Make this line and that axis collinear and give those dimension. This might be, yeah, 6 is okay, and another one again, 6, close. Now move this point a little bit up, maybe like this, that line a little bit up, and that one as well, maybe like this, and yeah, maybe like that. Yeah, that's okay. Now finish that sketch. Now project those lines to that surface. So go for curve, project curve. First project this one, but only one single curve, this one, into that surface. Along what direction? This direction, but the other way around. Apply. Then single curve this one to that surface along the same vector as before. Apply, and the last one, this one, to that surface along same direction, and okay. So I will change the lines a little bit. Go to that sketch. Really, that's over constraint. That tangent constraint should be removed. Okay. And let's change the lines a little bit. Move this up. And again, don't catch that tangent constraint. I could go for Alt, move this up, this a little bit up, and that a little bit up, maybe like this. Finish that sketch, and this projected line should change as well. Let's hide that sketch, this one, and now I need some section surfaces. So go for surface, more section surface, circular one, and make it radius 1 millimeter constant. You could change this, and one guide would be this one, and the same spine curve. Should be a sheet, of course. Apply, then use this one, same spine curve is the same, again a sheet, apply, and once more, same spine curve, make it a sheet, and okay. Oh, that's too long. So go for sketch. This curve is, it's somehow snapped right there, so I'm not able to move it, so I will trim it. Let's draw a line maybe up here and trim. Now I can remove that line again. Go finish sketch, and it's more like it. Now hide those projected curves as well. I could do this, of course, with my tool, hide curves. And of course, hide sketches. Let's hide this for a moment. That would be the last Sioux. There's this one. Hide. And I need some fills. So go for surface fill right here. Apply right there. Apply here. Apply. And on the other end as well. Apply. That's very similar to the Couture version. Now sew those together. So sew that surface, this one, that one, apply this one, that one, this one, this one, apply, and this, that, this. Okay, now I can trim. So let's show our, not this one, but where's my last Sioux? That's Sioux, Sioux, Sioux. Should be this one. Let's take a look. Yeah. Okay, now let's trim. In the next version, the trim command will be much better than now in NX 12. Trim sheet. I want to trim. Let's take a look. I want to trim this one with that one, with the Sioux. Let's take a look with that Sioux, and I want to keep the selected. Apply. Then I want to trim this one with that Sioux. Apply. And I want to trim this one with that Sioux. No, not this one, but maybe that one. Nope. That's the last one. Yes, and okay. Now I could hide those Sioux and take a look if it worked. It did. Now I can go back to my mirror. Yep, and back to my Sioux. Nice. and the upper part is done. So let's go for the grip. That feature group should not be active. And I could hide that feature group. Okay, I could show it again, of course, and everything is shown, so let's hide the sketches and the curves. Okay, I need a plane. And that would have an offset from this one in the other direction, and that might be 135. Okay, and then I need a sketch on that plane. And this should be an ellipse, and that ellipse, let's take a look. Where is the ellipse? Oh, there you go. Center should be on that axis, yes. And drag it a little bit in that direction, maybe like this, and then drag it maybe like that. Yeah, and okay. Finish that sketch. Now, yeah, that's too big, so let's move it a little bit over here. Yeah, I could change it anyway later. Now I need a sketch on that plane, and I will do it similar to the Katia version. I need two splines. First one, which should look something like this. Okay, maybe move this a little bit over here, maybe like that. Yeah, that's okay. And another spline, and this could look something like that. Okay, now let's try the swept, if it works. Finish that sketch and go for a swept. Surface or just home and swept. I need, of course, a sheet. The profile would be this one. And the guide one would be this one. Add another one, which is right there. Make sure the direction is the same and confirm. That's a little bit too big, so I will have to change my ellipse slightly at least. So go to the sketch, that was this sketch, and change the ellipse. Maybe like this, and maybe even a little bit smaller. Finish that sketch and take a look. Yeah, that's better. Okay, I could hide that feature group, adjust that geometry. Yeah, and this geometry as well. I'll just hide the feature group. That one, hide it completely. Make this a new feature group. A feature group, and call this grip. Okay, I could hide those sketches. So, hide sketches. I need an offset face from this one. So go for surface, offset surface to this one. And of course it should be on the inside. 2 millimeter would be okay. Okay. And then I need another sketch. And that would be on a plane which is not visible right now. So go for show the planes. Yeah, on this plane. A sketch. Right here. Confirm. And that would be another ellipse. So go for an ellipse. This should be somehow aligned there. So maybe like this and make it smaller, for example. Okay, and these 2 points should be aligned vertical, so it's in the center. Finish that sketch and make an extrude with that one. Extrude with this one, make it a sheet, turn it around. That's okay. Confirm. Now I want to trim this one with that one. So go for surface, trim sheet. I want to trim this surface with that one, and the selected should be discarded. Okay, so there should be a small surface inside that. I need an offset surface to this one, so go for offset this one. Now it should go, yeah, 2 millimeter is okay. Now I could hide that one. It's the sketch. Now that's that one, and now I have to trim this, trim sheet, this one with that one, but now I want to keep the selected region and okay. Hide this. Yeah, that's what I wanted. So let's close that gap, and I could do it with the curves. I will select that edge, add another one, select this edge, and make it G1 tangent to that surface, and G1 tangent to that surface, and okay. So if that's too steep, you could add it that offset surface, this one, and make it just 1 millimeter. Then it will look a little bit smoother. Now I could put those into that feature group. And maybe I have to sew this one, that one, and this one. Okay. Move this up and make this feature group the active feature group. Okay, now let's take a look. I might trim that sheet. Go for that through that last sew. This should be the sheet body. And I want to trim it with that plane. So that's the curves, and that's not inside the feature group. That's the problem. This should be. It's in the feature group, yes. Or is it? That's so should be all together Let's go for a sheet for face body. Solid body, sheet body, there we go. That's kind of irritating. Let's delete this one and try it once again. Make this the active group. And now sue this one, that one, and this one. Okay. Now it's okay. I want to trim that one. Go to trim sheet. I want to trim that sue right here with that plane. And I want to keep this side. Okay. So this. Make this card. Okay. And now I could make a fill right here, or I could make a bounded plane and make a fill. Let's try a full surface. That edge, yeah, let's leave it like this. That's okay. And sew it, this one and that one. Okay, now I want to see from that feature group the last sew. Show. Now I need to trim. Go to trim sheet. I want to trim this one right here, and I want to keep the selected part, and I want to trim it with that one, and that would be the body faces should be all together. Yes, apply, that's okay. Now trim that one with this one. Again, I want to with this one, and okay, nice. Now sew this with that. Okay, and now make a fillet. Go for home, edge blend, and blend this edge right here with 10, or yeah, 10 is okay. And I'm done. So I hope you enjoyed this one. If you liked it, please give it a like. That's almost too big. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page, and please like it. Would be very nice of you. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.